Hi, this is Karen Greenhouse, and today I'm going to show you one of the menu items or apps that's on the Casio CG50. It also can be put on other graphing calculators. It's a downloadable app if it's not already on there. So the reason I'm doing this is because I got a question on YouTube about how to use the constants, and I didn't know what the question meant, and they were talking about, and I'm going to arrow down to this, the Physium application. So I'd never explored this myself since I'm not a science teacher. So I went and explored it. So I thought I'd kind of share what it is because I don't think people realize that there's these amazing apps that are on this graphing calculator. And so if you hit, I went down to Physium, I could have done Alpha L, I'm going to hit execute and it opens up. And there's two choices. You have the periodic table or the fundamental physical constants, which is what the question was about. But I want to first look at periodic table. So it's chosen, I'm going to hit execute, and you can see it's the periodic table. Very small, can't see it, but you can search, you can look at the series, you can make it large. So if I hit F4, I can actually see these as I'm going through them, and I can arrow to different elements within the table, right? So let's hit execute back. I can look at a series of them, so I can look at the, let's look at the Earth series, and it shows me the series here, and I can go into the Earth ones, the gas, those types of things. Now, I'm not a scientist, so I'm not exactly sure what I'm looking at here, but that's not the point. The point is there's this amazing app in here. What I found as I was searching, though, let's go large again. I can get details. So if I arrow to one of the elements in this chart, let's choose this one, and I hit F6 for detail. This is what I love. This would be such an amazing support for students who are in science class because it tells you what it is. It gives you some detail. It gives you the weight. It gives you interesting things about it. It's used to in match heads, gives you a real world example. So we can go to another one. Let's pick one of these gray ones here and hit detail again. And this is gallium metal. And again, it gives me an example of where it's used, what its weight is, that type of thing. Just, I think this is so exciting that this is in here. Another thing that you can do is, let's say you don't know the metal you're searching for, but you know its atomic weight, right? So you can search these by name, symbol, number, or weight. So if students are, oh, I don't remember what the name of this is, but I know it's the atomic number that, they can go into number and put in the atomic number and search for it. Or if they know the weight, they can, let's exit out here. If they know the symbol, if they know what the symbol is, they can type the symbol in and it will, or they can search. You'll notice that in symbols, we actually have all the symbols and their weights here. So I can choose one. Let's choose this one. And it shows me where it is in the table. I can then look at its symbol, its weight, all those interesting things about it. So this is an amazing resource. Just a very simple app. Periodic table gives you lots of information. Great use for students. So let's exit back out. And that was a periodic table. So let's go down to the fundamental physical constants, which is what the question that originally got me into this app was looking for. So again, I'm arrowed down to it and I hit execute. And you'll notice that they're categorized by physical, chemical, atomic and nuclear, electromagnetic, universal. So if I just choose one of this, I think electromagnetic sounds interesting. So let's choose that. And it's all the different constants for electromagnetic. And the question that actually came up in the process was, how do I use these constants in a calculation, right? So what I found is you can store them alphanumerically. So let's say, let's go with this one. Let's say, and I'm sorry, again, not a scientist, so I don't know what this represents, but we're going to go with GO. And I want to store it. So I'm going to say, okay, store this. And it's going to store it in the alpha memory. So let's make it make sense. I'm storing this. So I'm going to store it as a G and I'm going to hit execute. Now it's stored. So then let's store, I don't know, this one, R. Again, sorry, not a scientist, so I don't know what these mean. I'm pleading ignorance here. So let's store this as R. I have to actually use my alphanumeric key here, and I was using my keyboard, but alphanumeric, where is the R? There it is. So I'd hit that. So and I hit execute. So I've got G and R stored in there. So then how would I use it in the calculation? Well, I can store as many as I want. I need to make sure I remember what I stored them as. I'm going to hit exit. And by the way, you can get detail on the constants. Oh, so this is the von Klitzing constant. So that's good to know. So hit exit. So now I'm going to go to menu and I'm going to go back to number one. So I'm just going to hit numeric to get myself back there, which is the math. That's the run matrix, right? So I'm going to hit execute again. And so now what did I save? I saved a G and R. Let's say I want to do a calculation, which this probably makes no sense to scientists, and I apologize, but I'm trying to show you how you can use these constants by saving them in the alpha numeric storing, and now you can use it in a calculation. So let's just do something simple. So I'm going to do alpha G times alpha R, I think is what we did, right? And let's hit execute, and I get an answer. Obviously, those were simple numbers, but this is just another way to use this menu item. So let's go back down to our Physium. So again, periodic table, fundamental constants. I'm sure there's a lot more that you can do with it, but it's got the constants that you might need in different calculations. And oops, I went to the wrong thing here. So let's cross that out. So different constants, it tells you about them. You can store them. You can edit them, which is also something that I found very interesting. You can actually edit them. Maybe it's too many decimals, or you want to just have it down to tenths, those kind of things. You can save and edit them if you want to do that. You can set them back to their initial if you want to. You can set them all back to their initial. You can get their details. So this is a really nice resource for students who are working in science and need to look up something. They don't remember what it means. The name, it's all right there on the calculator.